you. Thank you for coming out to our first concert of 2020. 2020. Yay. Makes me feel really old. I don't know why. For some reason it does. I'm glad you could be here tonight. We got a couple things I want to make announcements about before we get started. First of all, if you have a sub-sale form, we want to make sure we get that turned in tonight. So if you can get that to either Mr. Ragland or me or one of the band boosters, so we can get those all collected. Today's the deadline for our sub-sale forms. We'll get those in. Also, students, band journals are due. And if you don't have them in yet, you do have one last opportunity. Mr. Ragland and I will be working hard tomorrow during the teacher workday. So you can bring your band journal on by. If you need to bring it by tomorrow, I would like somebody to bring it by around breakfast time. Bring us a little something for breakfast. And then somebody can bring something by around lunchtime. And you can bring us a little lunch as well. So that'll be your penance for turning in your band journal late. So if you have your band journal, make sure we get those turned in. Mr. Ragland and I are going to try to get those all graded up this weekend. If you look at your program on the back, you can see the upcoming events. We do have a band booster meeting. It's on Tuesday next week. Is that correct, band boosters? Make sure I don't mess that up, because there is no school on Monday. So we have the band booster meeting on Tuesday. It's at 6 p.m. It'll be right over here in the orchestra room. And we're at that time of the year where our senior band booster parents are seeing the light at the end of the tunnel and thinking about life beyond the band boosters, and it's time for the underclassmen parents to start stepping up and filling some of those roles that those senior parents have taken care of. So we really appreciate a big turnout for our band booster meeting. We do have two basketball games remaining, one on January 24th and then the last one on February 4th. And again, the students need to have four of those six basketball games for their third 9 weeks grade, so we want to make sure we get that taken care of. And you'll be getting information through the Facebook page and through email about our big mattress fundraiser that's coming up on February 27th, or 22nd, I'm sorry. And we want to get all the information out for that. So you just take a look at those things, we'll get all those things taken care of. But I'm going to go ahead and turn it over to Mr. Ragland and the concert band. Thank you for coming tonight.
Thank you. Didn't they do a great job on that last week? Sometimes the slow and pretty song is harder than the fast and exciting Star Wars song, you know. And I apologize for spoiling Star Wars to your young people. You know, I told them the part where Jar Jar Binks becomes the Sith Lord. You know, I thought that was interesting. And we compared how the music, you know, followed that, you know. And then, of course, we talked about a serious subject such as Gettysburg. So, you know, they got to learn about, you know, the Civil War and whatnot, and how that, you know, affected our country and our peoples, and just how beautiful it is that today people from different backgrounds and what can come together and play music. So for a minute, we kind of forget our differences, and I think, not to make a political or a social point, but I think if you watch the news, it's nice to take a minute and we can all come together through music. So good job, young people. Next, we're going to play Legacy by James Swearingen. He's a familiar composer to all of us. He taught at Grove City for many years. He was also a teacher at Capital University. Myself, Mr. Hershey, and also Ms. Unger, who does the orchestra, all had the pleasure of having him in class. Mr. Sturm is the OSU fan, so it's been awkward since coming back from break, the whole Clemson thing. You know, I've been trying to be nice to him. But we're going to play Legacy, which is a band overture, so you're going to hear fast parts like you heard in Star Wars, and you're also going to hear beautiful, lush melodies like you heard in Gettysburg. So we're kind of taking in two different styles and putting them together. And this is called Legacy, an Overture for Band by James Swearingen.
Thank you.
it'll be a slight transition, and we'll have our wonderful symphonic band.
That was a Carl King march. I love Carl King marches. Carl King wrote all circus marches. And because he ran away and joined the circus, you guys have heard me tell you that before. But I love Carl King marches, and they just played it great today. Our next piece is something completely different. It's from the Wilson Suite. It's entitled In a Gentle Rain, and it features the baritone. And I recall a very young Mr. Ragland playing this piece when he was a senior in high school. 13 years ago, I'm going to try to make him feel old a little bit, although I was in high school a lot more years than that ago. He played it as a senior in high school, and we've got two outstanding baritone players this year in the symphonic band, so we thought we'd let them have a shot at it, and so they're splitting up the solo a little bit. So this is In a Gentle Rain from the Wilson Suite, and we're going to feature Kira Robinson first, and then Amari Simmons on the second half. Thank you. I was going to tell you about the snapping to simulate the sound of rainfall at the beginning of the piece, so subconsciously you'd be thinking that, but then I forgot. So the snapping simulated the rainfall. Hopefully you got that as we played that piece. Next up, we're going to play a piece from a 1961 musical called West Side Story. And I've been holding on to this little nugget all this time for the symphonic band here. I don't know if you guys are aware that Steven Spielberg is directing and producing a remake of this that is coming out in 2020. And it's the kid from Baby Driver, I don't know what his name is, he's the lead in that. So there'll be a new version of West Side Story produced and directed by Steven Spielberg out this year. So that's kind of interesting. So that's the reason I picked this piece, and I wanted to surprise these guys, because I don't think, did any of you guys know that? A couple people did. Yeah, I was trying to keep it a secret. So it's exciting that they're gonna remake it. Sometimes remakes aren't so great, but I think with Steven Spielberg at the helm, we might do okay. So these are some selections from West Side Story. Thank you. to spoil it for him, but I did tell him that it's not a happy ending at the end of West Side Story. I figured the movie came out in 1961. They probably should know by now, so I didn't wreck anything for him. Our last piece was kind of inspired by our time with our upperclassmen that did the District Honor Band. We played a piece called Abram's Pursuit by David Holsinger that the students really, really loved. And so we thought, how about we play something else by David Holsinger for the symphonic band. So this is a piece from the Class A list for large group contest. And this is a piece called Haven Dance. Thank you. Anyway, we want to thank you for coming out tonight. Let's hear another round of applause for the concert band who played for the band tonight. And students, how about a round of applause for our parents for buying our instruments and buying rings and taking us to lessons and all those things. Special thanks to Mr. Gibson, who came out tonight, and the whole administration at Franklin Heights, who are so supportive of everything we do. Have a great evening. Thank you so much for coming out tonight.